There's a reason why Penguin is playing on his skin that's in the game.
Yes. Dan was a fan of this man in particular because that's a nice little penguin-y boy over there.
Yeah. Like, Oof.
That's all you need sometimes.
Yeah. Listen, Penguin might be the one who is more globally renowned, but Akashi is certainly a threat of his own right. Manages the first stock, and we ought to be expecting these stocks to go flying as Akashi gets a little too frisky off stage and drops a stock to his own.
Yeah, hopefully not by each player's own volition in majority of them. But SDs happen, and you have to take them in stride. But it certainly gives Penguin a means to find their way back in this game, looking for another down smash, trying to challenge Penguin of how many times he's willing to DI up and away to get out of these tech chases.
Getting on those platforms is going to be so dangerous because it's just an absolute field of death. You get in the air just a tiny bit, and it's just staying there too long. Akashi managing to go on for the hunt, gets the stock on Penguin, but now has to figure out how to get back on stage.
It's going to be a tricky one for sure, especially with so many of these cloud setups coming out from Penguin. But if you're Akashi, I love how he's been playing this, trying to utilize that wall and always looking to get hit by the outside part of the cloud, because you'll take cloud damage over and over. You can find ways to recover through that. You can't always find ways to recover through Absaforiter. It does not get the sweet spot.
And that was beautifully DI'd too from Akashi. It's one of the things where you're like, this is a true reward for being so good with your character that you can go up against another notable name for your character. You play the mirror out so effectively because you know what the other opposite wants. And you know the timings too. An excellent parry on the up tilt.
The platform pressure from both players has been phenomenal, but Penguin starting to pull ahead in the latter half of this game, looking for something consistent. These up tilts coming out from both players against our rather airborne character, missing the parry on some of these clouds as we go back into a very awkward form of neutral as Penguin.
Okay. All right. The reversal there. I really didn't know which direction any of that was going to go because you saw the way that Akashi was trying to crouch, just waiting for the opportunity to find that up tilt. And one mistake with movement was all Penguin needed, and he was scouting for those little mistakes the entire game. Akashi gave it to him at the very end, and that's why game one goes to Penguin. With game two bringing us to treetop, there's a lot less room for error as Penguin explodes within the first 10 seconds.
Penguin is doing it to himself at this point, but I mean, that scoreboard tells you a reason. He may have some critical errors or be caught off guard by Akashi in some moments, but he's still Penguin, and he knows how to bring himself back. That stalwart mentality, excellent in a game where stocks can go flying just like that.
Yep. Ooh. Ooh, that was cute. Ending things off with a hit from the cloud as well. Just the conversions that Penguin's finding in this matchup are just marvelous because you don't know for certain if you're getting your sweet or sour spots or even your hits to begin with because Ops is such a mobile character.
And mobility is king in a game without the means to block. You have to focus on how you can get away from danger and not run face first into it. But unfortunately, Penguin was running out of options.
Yo. Yeah, like, I took a moment to talk about how good Penguin is with movement and positioning of the cloud. I gotta give it to Akashi for that one.
Oh, yeah.
Like, that was just so dangerous, and there was no chance that Penguin had the option of going high for the recovery. Otherwise, you're eating up air and you're dying anyways.
And Hangman, Frank is... excuse me. Akashi has been doing so well at managing risk-reward of situations where he's leaning onto these platforms and knowing what hits to take and what hits that he can afford to take without the stock dropping and without letting Penguin walk all over him. Especially so in this game, too, where he has a full stock advantage and he's not letting this go as easily as game one.
No, this is still very neck and neck, though, down to last stocks at high percentages, and it's really just going to take one hit off stage to end it. Even onstage battles proving to be fraught as one connection. Last stock time. Can Akashi finish this one out? Are we going to see another key reversal from Penguin take the game?
Yeah, that Nair is certainly a good one. Oh, finding a second one, looking to get an up air afterwards.
One more? Oh, that up tilt would have been curtains. That's so risky for Penguin, too, to play off that top plat.
But sometimes you have to risk it for this biscuit, and these top platforms is all Penguin is looking for. He's Penguin up B for a reason, but without a wall jump, that up B's not going to be able to save you anymore off of that great parry of the cloud. Just a little, a defensive tactic that you're used to getting away with, not so.
It's just such good scouting out from Akashi, too, because he's aware that that's something that he has to keep mindful of whenever he's off stage against any other player. Here, he's in a situation where he just knows the timing. It's happened to him so many times, he may as well have it happen to another Opsa. And what better an Opsa than Penguin? We got the 1-1 count now. And I think we could expect these games to go flying as quick as the stocks now, because any little hit that gets their target off stage just leads to absolute disaster. And I think that's exactly what's going to happen as Game 3 takes us to Julesville, which we've already seen is a devastating stage for Opsa today.
Yeah, just the amount of space, the opportunistic, how opportunistic you can be off of this sliding platform. The low ceiling certainly helping out to Opsa, having an up many finisher through the off the top. Not usually Cloud, but hey, you'll take those.
There's so many dangerous situations for Opsa to find themselves in when their target's able to control a platform so effectively. And when that target is Opsa, like, Opsa is able to make so much and is so little on this stage. Just the one little mistake that Penguin makes, and he gets his stock completely fried.
The littlest hit of Nair was all that Akashi needed, finding the very last hit and then chaining it to something so much more. Great DI, messing with these, missing the sweet hit up forward air too. But you're gonna get closed out off of up tilt, and that's something Penguin can do in his sleep, something that all Opsa players can do in their sleep, and consistency is king in a matchup where it is the ditto.
Couple of sour hits of dares just to rack up that damage. But Akashi needs to turn out these ledge situations similar to how Penguin is, where even if the damage isn't there, just scouting for the kill immediately has been working so well for Penguin. The 2-1 stock count didn't happen by accident. The fact that Penguin is dominating control of that platform and then forcing the battle to wherever the platform is leaning just makes all of that offstage play even more dangerous. But he don't need that platform to confirm kills here. 2-1 stock count goes to Penguin.
Wow, and that's a statement game from Penguin. And again, another game that makes Akashi like just... You have little things where you look back at game one, and you can't do this mid-set, but you gotta wonder, man, you had that lead in game one, and suddenly in a long set, Penguin starts to show his experience and begin to pull ahead a little bit, especially finding that first back air in game number four.
So game four is bringing us to Merchant Court. I think a fine choice, but we do need to see Akashi, I think, get just as risky offstage as Penguin has been. He needs to match that tempo, and that is a tall order. But if Akashi can consistently DI these aerials as well as he's been doing, it's very doable.
Yeah, you're finding ways to extend your life and extend trading on the F2. You're finding clean extensions, but it's only so much can really close down and lock down the gates from Penguin, who's been finding all different ways to mix up his movement. Akashi found some amazing surprises, but Penguin, no shortage of secrets up his own sleeves.
Oh, definitely. Oh! The tricky movement across the plats, too. Well-earned stock from Penguin. Glides across. Game 4 starting to look like a runaway game, but...
Yeah, well-earned lead from Penguin at this point. No signs of stopping. Just... These platforms are so beneficial for Opsa, but you've always got to worry about the reverse coin in a matchup like this as the upbeats come alive. Just moments where Penguin gives you room to breathe and then snuffs out that lifespan.
Ooh, what a good call with the upstrung too. Knew the parry was going to come, so he went for the slower option. If that was up tilt, that's it. That would have been the game. But instead, Akashi finding just a semblance of life here. It's still a grim situation, but Akashi going out with a fight.
And Opsa certainly has a lot of moves to cheat out stocks sometimes, so looking for one of those big haymakers, F-Strong could have been the doer.
But is up air that manages to finish out this one. It's a 3-1 count to Penguin as he advances on to winner's side top 8. Very well fought from Akashi, but if he's making this top 8 tonight, it's going to have to be from the lower end.
Cert got plenty of room in there going up against another player in that lower bracket. If he's playing as good as he did in this one, it's hard to take a game and almost two off of Penguin. That's a strong showing from Akashi, regardless of how the set resolved.
It's like there's very few players at the topmost level of Rivals who could do that to Penguin in any circumstance. I feel like there is no other obstacle besides Akashi who could threaten to do that in the mirror. Like, it's tough. And that is a credit to just how good of a player Penguin is. But it looked doable for Akashi. And I think that in itself is a credit to how well he's playing tonight.